The Owen James Report is brought to you by
Lasco Cambio. Lasco Cambio from Lasco Financial Services. Everyday financial value. Need foreign currency fast and want to get the most competitive rates? The best place to go is Lasco Cambio. We even have a drive-through Cambio service, safe and convenient. And did I mention fast? Lasco Cambio is the only name you need to know. Plus, you can do many other things, including wire transfers, bank drafts, and bill payments. The only name you need to know is Lasco Cambio. Lasco Cambio from Lasco Financial Services. Everyday financial value.
Good evening. This is the Owen James Report. Finance Minister Dr. Peter Phillips opened the debate on the 2014-2015 budget of $540 billion with a strong focus on the growth agenda. Citing three consecutive quarters of growth in the Jamaican economy, Dr. Phillips emphasized that a return to growth despite economic difficulties is the most encouraging news for the administration. He noted that last year such growth climaxed with 1.8% growth in the December quarter and announced preliminary projections of 1.7% growth in the January to March quarter. He also emphasized that the administration plans to stay the course towards a growth agenda. So how does the administration plan to fund the $540 billion budget for the current fiscal year? Well, revenues and grants are expected to fund over 78% of the budget.
Revenues and grants are projected at $421.2 billion, leaving a financing gap of $118.9 billion. This will be financed by loan receipts of $110 billion, utilization of balances in the banking system of $1.4 billion, and inflows from new measures totaling $6.7 billion.
The shortfall in the budget is to be funded by new taxes required to allow the administration to meet its primary surplus target.
The tax package being proposed is approximately 0.5% of GDP.
The new taxes will have an impact on personal investment instruments such as insurance.
It is proposed that the rate of tax on gross premiums be increased to a standard 5.5%. The second change being proposed is to increase the 15% income tax on net investment income to 20% for all insurance companies. The new regime will be effective May 1st, 2014, and the total revenue yield from the combined measures would be approximately $1 billion.
Phillips outlined to Parliament today what he identified as the basic prerequisites for growth: easy access to affordable credit, efficient government institutions, a more efficient legal system, and a society that rewards business endeavors. On the foreign exchange market, amidst continued strong demand for hard currency, the Jamaican dollar weakened against the benchmark American dollar, with the exchange rate closing in on the $110 Jamaican to one US dollar mark. In actual trading, the greenback strengthened by 5 Jamaican cents, closing at an average selling rate of $109.95, whilst the British pound advanced by 21 cents Jamaican to close at $184.59. However, the Canadian dollar weakened by $1.03 Jamaican to close at $99.84. News on the Jamaican stock market now, where amidst moderate activity which saw just over 2 million shares changing hands and an advance decline ratio of 5 to 10, the indices experienced mixed fortunes. The main JC index advanced by 23 points or 0.03%. 23 stocks traded, with 5 advancing, 10 declining, and 8 holding firm. The winners were Carreras, Dolphin Cove, Jamaican Teas up 9.4%, the day's big winner, the preference stock Proven 8%, and Scotia Investments. The losers included Caribbean Cement, Consolidated Bakeries down 12%, Kingston Wharves, NCB, Sagicor Group Jamaica, and Scotia Group Jamaica. And that's the Owen James Report. Good evening.
The Owen James Report was brought to you by
Lasco Cambio. Lasco Cambio from Lasco Financial Services. Everyday financial value.